been charging to get into Bloomfield Road, Matthew Rush would have been worth the admission fee on his own. The pass that sent Jason Bowen through to shoot wide was just one of many moments of skill which the striker himself couldn't quite match. Bowen sending his shot wide of the keeper, but wide of the far post as well. Another splendid piece of play by Rush showed just how lucky Swansea are to have him on loan from West Ham, and also made you wonder how well he might do in the Premiership itself. This time his pass saw Bowen up the ball onto Sean Chappell, but his shot lacked the power to trouble Steve McElhardy. Chappell turning well enough, but unable to get any kind of pace on the ball. 5 minutes into the second half came one of those incidents that has people in sports quizzes asking what happened next. What happened here was a crunching challenge by substitute Andy Gook on the referee. Andy Gomez down and out, and Gook didn't even get a yellow card. A game lad, the referee. He got up after that and staggered about for a while, but eventually had to hand over the whistle to one of his linesmen. That meant he didn't see another bit of bizarre football, which had John Ford lobbing the ball neatly over his own goalkeeper. Roger Freestone did well to scramble the ball away for a corner, unable to use his hands, of course, because of the back pass law. Perhaps Ford didn't know exactly where his keeper was, but it's still difficult to work out just what he was trying to do. In spite of all that, Swansea had been in control for most of the match, and it was a real surprise when Blackpool took the lead. A neat build-up by the home side, but the Swans really given them far too much time and space to play. The ball was finally worked to Andy Gook, who curled his shot around and over Roger Freestone. An eventful day for Gook, something else to celebrate besides hovering the ref, but no laughing matter for Swansea, one down after that with just 8 minutes left. They certainly didn't deserve to lose, and a fine crossfield ball from Sean Chappell began the move that saved the point. Jason Bowen picked it up on the right, Matthew Rush was inevitably involved, and his chip to the far post saw Steve Torby's diving header slowing through the fingers of Steve McElhardy. Relief for the Swans, who had been bitterly disappointed to leave Bloomfield Road empty-handed. Bowen giving Rush the chance to show his talents once again. A brave effort from Torby to get the header on target, but the keeper clearly disappointed. So 1-0 the final score, after all sorts of entertainment and a match nobody paid to see.
But they left it.